Let's see. So the first couple of people up are Tom Maynard, followed by Jan Luby. So if you're ready, Tom.
I am ready.
You can get going. There you go. Go ahead and unmute yourself.
I am unmuted. And welcome, everybody, to another Monday night. I'm going to start off with a Greg Brown tune. And then I'm going to try again with some an instrumental. But we're going to start here with Lord, I've Made You a Place in My Heart. It gets a little ribald in the middle, so, you know, close your ears if it's offensive. Oh, Lord, I've made you a place in my heart, among the rags and the bones and the dirt. There's piles of lies and the love gone from her eyes, and old moving boxes full of hurt. Pull up a chair by the trouble and care. I got whiskey, you're welcome to some. Oh Lord, I made you a place in my heart, but I don't reckon you're gone. Tried to fix up the place, you know it's a disgrace. You'll get used to it after a while. With the flood and the drought, and old friends hanging out with their IOUs and their smiles. Bare naked women keep coming in, and they dance like you would not believe. Oh Lord, I made you a place in my heart, so take a good look and then leave. Oh Lord, why does the fall get colder each year? And Lord, why kind can't I learn to love? Oh Lord, if you made me, it's easy to see. You all make mistakes up above. But if I open the door, you'll know that I'm poor, and my secrets are all that I own. Oh Lord, I made you a place in my heart, and I hope that you leave it alone.
Oh yeah. Good song.
Thank you. Big Brown. Next, I'm going to try a quick medley of Celtic tunes. This is the arrangements are by David Surrett. One is called the Road to Kirigo. I forget how it's pronounced. And then the second one is, I don't remember the name of that either, but I can put that in the chat window later. So a couple of arrangements by David Surrett.
Gorgeous.
That was great.
Love the Greg Brown song too.
Okay. Great song.
Thank you, Tom. So up next is Jen Luby. This is her first time at this virtual open mic. Some of us know her from other open mics, and I believe she has been to Ellen's physical open mic at some point.
It's been a long time.
It's been a long time, but you have
it's been. About an hour and a half for me usually to drive to that one.
So let's give Jan a big welcome. And after Jan would be Dave Mason. And then you can unmute yourself, Jan. You're muted still.
Yeah, this is a very November song. So I must do it. I don't do this crazy stuff. And I guess nobody's going to be doing it this year. But I have friends that actually do this, so you'll see. 'Tis the season to be jolly, radios playing songs of yore, hanging with friends and family, giving food and toys to the poor. But tonight I'm full of Thanksgiving dinner, my eyes are red and sore. It's the middle of the night, only a quarter to four, and we're waiting here in line. We're huddled at the door. When they open, we'll rush in, trample anything on the floor. Feeling anxious and afraid, finding comfort in a store. I'll be so happy once I have newer, bigger, better, more. We've worked out our strategies. We've done it all before. The best one, the first 100 in, we'll get the best sales for sure. Oh no, they're almost gone. Hey, what'd you do that for? I saw it first. Give it back. Hey, buddy, this is war. Feeling anxious and afraid, finding comfort in a store. I'll be so happy once I have newer, bigger, better, more. Tis a season to be jolly. Yeah.
Wait, did you write that, Jan?
Yeah. Nobody else would write anything like that.
It's called Black Friday. That's hilarious.
You can tell it's a pretty old song. It's on Nobody's Girl, and Jeff Bartley's playing on it too. Because now, well, not now, because who knows what's going to happen this year, but in years after I wrote that song, they started opening the stores earlier and earlier, till the point where it was like midnight on Thanksgiving night. So you'd like rush off to go shop. I don't know. I never did it, but I also had friends that had their kids in line for forever waiting for the Harry Potter book, the next Harry Potter book. It's like, buy it when you can get it. You know, it's like you're going to wait all night in line with a sleeping bag. It's crazy stuff. Anyway, but I digress. This is a Rachel Bissick song, and I don't know if anybody of you know her, or knew her, I should say, because she's no longer in her earth suit. But she wrote really gorgeous songs, and she was a wonderful performer and a stellar human being, and I haven't played this song in a while, and I thought it was time. Figure if I do one snarky song, I have to do one nice one, you know. When I tried to dance with you and stepped all over your feet, you said, just 1, 2, 3, don't look down. So I looked full in your face and met your wet and shining eyes, and you said, don't look away, stay with me, don't be afraid to love, 'cause we were made to love. You haven't time to let your fears be your guide. Don't be afraid to love, 'cause we were made to love. Just close your eyes, step gently by my side. We reached out for each other in that sea of many people, and you said, hold on to me. I felt your body pressed against me, and my breath caught short within me, and you said, don't pull away, stay with me, don't be afraid to love, 'cause we were made to love. You haven't time to let your fears be your guide. Don't be afraid to love, 'cause we were made to love. Just close your eyes, step gently by my side. Just close your eyes.
that's a beauty. That's a beauty.
Does anybody know Rachel? Do you know Rachel?
I know of her, of Rachel. I never
loved her. Oh, she was wonderful. Thanks so much, you guys.
Jan, can I ask you a question? In the ASL interpreter world, do you know Diana Mealy?
Oh, in the Boston area?
Yeah.
I might. I knew a Diana that was in an interpreter, but it was years ago when I lived in the Boston area. Uh-huh. So I'm not sure if it's the same person.
Oh, yeah, it probably is. Because it's not.
I'm down in Rhode Island now, so.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you, Jan. Great song. Okay, up next is Dave Mason, who is also first time with Virtual Mic, and I'm not sure if he's ever made a physical one, but he's welcome. And then following Dave will be Mark Evans. So Dave, you can unmute yourself when you are ready.
Okay. Hey, everyone. How's everyone doing? I'm based in Cincinnati. The first song I'm going to sing, one of my songs and then a song of a friend of mine. So this is a song I wrote. It's about this time of the year, and it's called The Bounty of the Harvest. Days are getting shorter, nights are closing in, farmers are out working in the field. Morning's feeling colder, soon there will be frost again, when the bounty of the harvest is revealed. Pray for sunshine, hope for rain, cherished farmers, give us grain. Squashes, pumpkin, and potato will sustain us in our need. Barley, wheat, and corn, our trusty shield. Every autumn tells of fables, expectations we'll exceed, when the bounty of the harvest is revealed. Pray for sunshine, hope for rain, cherished farmers, give us grain. Yet the busy, struggling farmers work each day without a care, like soldiers toiling on the battlefield. Without rifle, without armor, victory will soon be theirs, when the bounty of the harvest is revealed. Pray for sunshine, hope for rain, cherished farmers, give us grain. Pray for sunshine, hope for rain, cherished farmers, give us grain. Now life is somewhat like the harvest, days of sunshine and of rain, our circumstances like the fallow field. Our friends are like the blessed farmers, their seeds of love will ease our pain, with this love our bruises will be healed. So pray for sunshine, hope for rain. Cherished farmers, give us grain. Pray for sunshine, hope for rain. Cherished farmers, give us grain. There we go, the bounty of the harvest.
Beautiful.
So, you know, this online performing, it's got its own challenges. You know, I was on a call this afternoon. My sound was perfect. I just like... And then I didn't touch anything, didn't change anything, went away, had prepared dinner, came back. It was like crazy. It's crazy. So I've spent the last 45 minutes trying to get my sound right again. But
sounds great.
Anyway, so I as I said, I'm in Cincinnati. I am an Englishman, and we are here on work visas. So we will be returning to Europe next year, COVID allowing. Or permitting. But I spent most of my life growing up in Johannesburg in South Africa, actually, and I spent time playing folk music in and around South Africa, different folk clubs and different folk festivals. And there's a woman called Fiona Tozer. It's T-O-Z-E-R, T-O-Z-E-R. She is a singer-songwriter from just outside of Durban in KwaZulu-Natal. And she's written some fantastic stuff, and you can check her out on fionatozer.com if you'd like. Anyway, this is a song that she wrote back in the early 90s. And I remember the first time I heard it, and still to this day, actually. As a songwriter, it's one of those songs where you wish you could have written a song like this because it's just so great. So I'm going to try and sing it without making too many mistakes. And it's a song about songwriting and being a songwriter and telling your story and allowing your story to come back whenever you want it to. And it's called Neverland. There's a place in your memory, time outside the day, full of dreams saved from childhood, when you've forgotten how to play. It lets you remember the feel of the wind in your face, and of long forgotten freedom of a distant time and place. You can take a trip to Neverland, but you'll always come around again. You can take a trip to Neverland. So you look to your lover, ask her to show you the way. Make love shine like a lighthouse in the frozen waters of the bay. But can you make it last forever? Try and hold it in your hand, or burn it in your memory as the tide turns on the sand. You can sail your ship to Neverland. But you'll always come ashore again, you can sail your ship to Neverland. And returning from the journey, looking back on where you've been, O spinner of the story, retrace your steps once again, and make it last forever, and make you understand that it's always there inside you, here and now is Neverland. You can sing your song in Neverland. It'll all come around again. You can sing your song in Neverland. There we go, Neverland.
Nice. Beautiful, Dave.
Thank you so much.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you, thank you. Unfortunately, there's already somebody's got my name.
Yeah.
Out there, so it's a bit difficult, you know.
Nope, it's happening again.
I'm at the Odeum last year.
Yeah. Yes, well, I didn't get excited expecting him to show, but... let's see. So up next is Mark Evans, and following Mark will be Woody. So Mark, you can unmute.
All right. This is a song I wrote to a prompt a little over a year ago. The prompt was Turtle Shell. Go figure. So this is a song came out of it. I'm, you know, the prompt was challenging, but the song turned out pretty good, I think so. Found a turtle shell on a beach one day, and I had to think it queer how the turtle could come to lose a thing so obviously dear. As I pondered this, I realized, much to my dismay, that I knew just how the turtle felt on the day you walked away. I saw a rabbit's foot hanging on a pole in a booth at the county fair, and I wondered how that rabbit felt and if he had the foot to spare. As I made my way back home alone, I really think I knew the way that poor old rabbit felt on the day when I lost you. Like an ocean without a swell, like a flower without a smell, like a wizard without a spell, yeah, that's me. Like a dog without a bone, I'm gonna live my life alone. Like a turtle without a shell, yeah, that's me. Saw a hot rod at an auto show with a foxtail flying high. And I bet that fox, when he lost that thing, had to sit right down and cry. Does he wander through the forest now in a daze the way I do? Does he miss his long and fluffy tail as much as I miss you? Like an ocean without a swell, like a flower without a smell, like a wizard without a spell, yeah, that's me. Like a dog without a bone, I'm gonna live my life alone. Like a turtle without a shell, yeah, that's me. Like a hammer without a nail, or a handle without a pail, like a schooner without a sail, yeah, that's me. Like a traveler without a home, I'm gonna live my life alone. Like a turtle without a shell, yeah, that's me. Like a turtle without a shell.
I was sort of expecting a political thing about Mitch McConnell.
not an easy prompt, that one.
Yeah.
You got a good song out of it.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah.
So I was riding around on my motorcycle up in New Hampshire a few months back, and this chorus kind of came into my head, and I had been thinking about Black Lives Matter for a long time, and watching what was going on, and felt like there was a song someplace in there, someplace in here, for it. By the time I got back from the ride, I had the chorus in my head. It only took me weeks to come up with the verses and the rest of it, but. So this song is a tribute to Black Lives Matter, and it's called Bitter Wind. Walking home, and no matter what they say, you know he's not the only one. Oh, oh. There's a dark cloud that brings the rain, a bitter wind brings the pain, makes our children moan and grieve and kneel and cry. We cannot breathe, and it's a cruel storm. Brings the death, a bitter wind steals the breath. Gone the children's joy and laughter, gone the lives we should have mattered. Standing in the flames of a nation torn by hate and blame. Where those who should protect are the authors of the greatest pain. You can take a bullet in your back when your only crime is driving black. Half of us refuse to call it by its proper name. Oh, oh, there's a dark cloud that brings the rain. A bitter wind brings the pain. Makes our children moan and grieve and kneel and cry. Cannot breathe, and it's a cruel storm. Brings the death. A bitter wind steals the breath. Gone the children's joy and laughter. Gone the lives. It should have mattered. All the pain and rage has them locked up in a cage and left beneath the boiling sun. So open up your eyes and you won't be surprised at the revolution when it comes. There's a dark cloud that brings the rain. A bitter wind brings the pain. Makes our children moan and grieve and kneel and cry. We cannot breathe and it's a cruel storm. Brings the death. A bitter wind steals a breath. Gone the children's joy and laughter. Gone the lives. It should have mattered. I said gone the lives. Should have mattered.
Let's see. So Woody is up next. Woody made it back in. And then Mom was scheduled, but Mom hasn't made it to the meeting yet. So after Woody, I'll have to mute you, Woody. And then you can unmute. Are you still muted?
Hello.
There you are.
There we go. I don't know what happened. I must have hit a wrinkle in the space-time continuum. Die. you want a man like me. Well, baby, don't you want a man like me? You gotta think about your future, forget about your used to be. Is long and dreary and the sun refuses to shine. You know I'm in heaven while I hold you in my arms. That's the truth, baby. Don't you know I wouldn't lie? You know if I can't have you, baby, don't you throw out hope to die.
Sweet, Woody.
That was awesome.
I had the opportunity once to play with a couple of songs with what's his name? Ronnie, the blues guy there. He was saying that I've been playing that song fast all my life. And
is it Ronnie Earl?
Ronnie Earl.
Yeah.
He says, you know, you play the song slow. You can't. All the feeling comes out of it when you're slow. When you're fast, all you can do is. Mm-hmm. But he said the feeling is in the slow tunes, and that finally sunk into my squash.
Speaking of squash, Woody, did you ever figure out if that was a rutabaga?
I don't know what it was. I think it was some Klingon fruit or something. I don't know what happened, man. Well, Ronnie Earl, or not, here's with another one. This is one I wrote called Squid Beaks. Thank you.
speaks. Whoa. Very nice. Awesome.
It's moodier every time I hear it.
It's different every time I play it. Just, that's what comes up.
More tentacles. More beeps, whichever it is. Okay, up next. Thank you, Woody. Up next is Ruth Canonico. This is Ruth's first time at the virtual open mic, though we know her from the others. Following Ruth will be Dave Diamond. So, Ruth, you can unmute yourself.
Am I unmuted?
You are unmuted.
Okay. All right, everybody's been singing beautiful, happy songs, and I'm going to read to you from my submission that was to Hoppington's poetry and story anthology. I don't know if any of you know Cheryl Pearl and her friend Cynthia have put out a book, which has just been finally published, of stories from people in the community who wanted to share a story about how they're feeling hopeful or positive during this very peculiar time of pandemic. So I'm going to take a chance here and read it. All right, you all set? So as they say on the British radio, they say, are you all sitting comfortably now? Okay. So what it is the title is What Doesn't Kill Us Makes Us Strong. And I just looked at the date. I wrote this almost 6 months ago. So I don't know if you've got the picture up, Dan, the picture that I have up.
Picture's fine.
Okay. So this was written 29th of May, 2020, 6 months ago almost. As we move into the week 11 of the lockdown of the pandemic, oh, I took my glasses off, that was silly. I, like many others, feel the sense of unreality as so much of our lives has been put on hold. We still do not know how long this paralysis of our daily lives will be halted by the need to stay sequestered. We hope for our lives to resume some semblance of normality in the near future, but we cannot know how long that will take. I am of an age and such medical conditions as to have made me more restricted in my movements than most, added to which I live alone. As there is no one to share my experience of day-to-day, face-to-face, hand-to-hand, and voice-to-voice, how do I manage to sustain my sanity? For one, I have lived more and more in unsolicited solitude for almost 2 decades. My mobility handicaps have restricted me from the work I love, teaching music to young children in schools. As my painful encroaching arthritis has taken hold most of my weight-bearing joints, my back and my hands and shoulders, I've been less able to even attend the concerts, open mics, and events I so enjoy. Ah, now, but where is the hope in this story? Where is the inspiration of how I'm managing this isolation? Young children should not listen to the next part, okay? Let me take you back to an evening 57 years ago in October. This was my sophomore year in high school. It was an exciting time of growing up and exerting my independence, albeit with resistance from my good yet conservative but loving parents. On that night, as 5 young people returned home from a youth roller skating party, driven by a 19-year-old friend of my brother's, a terrible accident was caused by wet and leaf-covered roads and street lamps without lights in them, and sent us into a skid that ended up with a car wrapped around a telegraph pole. Life changed unalterably for us all. 2 died, 1 never regained normal consciousness, and only 2 survived, my 19-year-old brother and me. The difference between us was he flew out of the front broken windshield, sustaining only shock and a skinned elbow, and I was trapped in the car by both legs, 1 in the front under the front seat, broken at the ankle, and 1 in the back seat. The side back window put out by my head and a compound fracture of my right thigh in 33 places. You have a drink of water if you need it. As words are not enough to tell all, I will go to the comparison with my present isolation and a sense of paralysis. For 3 months, I was in traction in a hospital bed, sharing the 2-person room with a succession of adults ranging in age from 19 to 87. During which time parents and friends of my brother and I visited regularly, driving the amicable ward nurse to distraction with our hootenannies. My mother began reading to me chapters from Alice in Wonderland and Through the Looking Glass, in afternoon visits that she continued when I was at home for 2 months in a cast that went up my right leg and around my hips. I had 1 tutor, a delightful retired English teacher with upswept blue tinted hair, who taught me how to write from my own experience. Another woman from our church came and taught me how to hand sculpt with clay, and she told me wonderful stories of her antics as a youth and since. My father always prayed with me at the end of each visit to the hospital. I did sleep a lot, watching the little television someone gave me, and talked with my changing roommates, learning from their very different lives and experience. Of course, there were no internet distractions or cell phone communications, but I kept engaged in life from my hospital bed as I slowly healed. Isn't this what we're all asked to do more or less now as we practice staying at home or social distancing and wearing a face mask covering masks? We need to make the most of the world around us as it is now and maybe for quite some time to come. If I could do this at 15, I must be able to do it at 71, 72 tomorrow, by the way, and beyond. I also never forget that three young people never had the opportunity to explore life as I have since my recovery. God bless all who have not made it through the virus, as well as all who have. I thank God every day for friends, for music, for poetry, for plays, worship services, and all we can see and share through the internet, the telephone, and letters, and even handwritten to stay in touch. And this was May, so I said, spring foliage, flowers, and birds carry on as always, and my past and present are intertwined. And I'll just end, if it's all right, Dan, with the song that I sang when I was in the ambulance, being carried in the ambulance, my parents absolutely deranged. You can imagine if you have children, what you've just seen. And your daughter says, Daddy, can you sing me a song while you're in the ambulance? And he said, no, honey, I can't. My mother said, I said, Mom, can you sing me a song? And she said, honey, I can't sing anything right now. So on the way to the hospital in an ambulance with these two badly broken legs and a head, you know, that knocked out a window with all that went on, this is what I sang. And if you know it, sing along whether you're muted or not. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Children of the cross. And every rung goes higher, higher. Every rung goes higher, higher. Every rung goes higher, higher. Children of the cross. Oh, sinner, do you love your Jesus, sinner? Do you love your Jesus, sinner? Do you love your Jesus, children of the cross? Well, if you love him, why not serve him? If you love him, why not serve him? If you love him, why not serve him, children of the cross? For we are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Children of the world. Thank you very much. And you can get the book from Cheryl if you want it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very moving.
Okay. Give us a moment to recover from that.
Yeah, very nice, Ruth. Thanks.
Next up is David Diamond, and then following David would be Snake. So I'm going. And David, you can unmute yourself.
I have done so, yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Yes. I changed my mind about what I was going to sing after hearing that. I think I was going to sing something a little a little dark. But maybe I'll just go for one of my funniest things, which is a Cockney song. It's one of my favorites. It needs to be sung fast sometimes. And as a young father with a, I guess she was a 10-year-old in the car coming back on long trips, we would indulge in races to see who could sing it fastest. And the answer is her. But here we go. Oh, Jimmy Dean was a funny looking fella. If he had a bigger mouth, you'd have took it for a seller. And his mouth quit him from winning the beauty show. Cause it was like a steamboat funnel or a railway arch or the Black Walk Tunnel. And you can't see Jim when he opens his mouth, you know. And as our Jimmer goes a-walking all about, you can hear the kids all hollering out. What a mouth, what a mouth, what a north and south. Blimey, what a mouth he's got. When he was a baby, look, all Lovell, his poor old mother used to feed him with a shovel. What a gap. Poor chap. He's never been known to laugh, cause if he did, it's a penny to a quid, his face would fall in half. Oh, mouth so large for law, call lummy, he can whisper in his own ear, ain't he funny, and to quench his thirst, he has to have a drink of a mild. He got so drunk one foggy dawn, and he laid in the street, he started to yawn, and a poor old man was delivering the coals close by. And as he went to shoot his load, he saw Jim's mouth out in the road. Now this old man, being a short-sighted fellow, well, he saw Jim's mouth, took it for a seller, and he shot the lot right into Jim's mouth, no joke. Now Jim, poor soul's got a belly full of coal, and he coughs up lumps of coke. What a mouth, what a mouth, what a north and south, blind what a mouth he's got. When he was a baby, look, all Lovell, his poor old mother used to feed him with a shovel. What a gap, poor chap. He's never been known to laugh, cause if he did, it's a penny to a quid, face would fall in half. Whoa. Now Jim in bed one night was snoring, and the neighbours all around thought the lion was a-roaring, and the old Dutch clock that was hanging on the bedroom wall, and to his mouth it fell, crash, wallop, dim, Jim woke and called for Dr. Jollops, and his wife, no fear, that's just the old Dutch clock, my dear. And now the neighbours, isn't it fine, look down Jim's throat to see the time. But his wife, my life, she can't get a wink of sleep, that's right, for inside his tum she can hear the pendulum going ticka-ticka-tock all night. Oh, what a mouth, what a mouth, what a north and south, blind what a mouth he's got. When he was a baby, look, all Lovell, his poor old mother used to feed him with a shovel. What a gap. Poor chap, he's never been known to laugh, cause if he did, it's a penny to a quid, face would fall in half. Oi! Oh, just a second, I need to get the last one. Well, you don't need the last verse. There you are. So,
that was fun.
Now for something truly miserable. I think I'm going to move to the. No. Yes. I'll, is that right? Yes. I'm going to move this way. And by my. Let me see. That's my right ear. You can see a fellow standing there. That's Dave Weber. who sings with Anne Fentiman over in England and comes over here from time to time. And they do wonderful things. And I was over there at a little festival at which they turned up. And they sang a song which was put into music, a poem by one of my favorite poets. Now, sad to say, it was A. E. Houseman. I don't know how many of you know A. E. Houseman, but it's beautiful, very clear poetry, which is good for me because I can't always understand what everybody, all the other poets are saying. But he's very clear. Unfortunately, he's a bloody miserable sod. But they made a beautiful song out of something, one of his perennial subjects, which was dying soldiers. So here we go. The Queen, she sent to look for me. The sergeant, he did say, young man, a soldier will you be? For 13 pence a day. For 13 pence a day did I put off the things I wore, and I did march to where I lie, whence I shall march no more. My coat is wet, my throat is dry, my blood runs all away. And yet I shall not die in debt for 13 pence a day. Tomorrow after new young men, that sergeant he must see. For things will all be over then between the Queen and me. And I will have to bate me price, for in the grave they say is neither pleasure nor device, nor 13 pence a day.
Houseman, huh?
Yeah.
Choice. Hey, up next is Snake, and following Snake will be Branson. So Snake, you can unmute.
Good evening, all. Some of you have heard this because I started playing it just a tad over a week ago, but it's still growing up, so I'm going to do it again. Written in 1954 by Bart Howard. Fly me to the moon and let me sing among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, be true. In other words, I love you. Fly me to the moon and let me see among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, in other words. In other words, I love you.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, that was nice.
I love the guitar playing too.
I'm going to do something different. It's coming up on Thanksgiving. And we've been all told a wonderful tale about the first Thanksgiving when the Native Americans and the Pilgrims sat down and ate turkey and apple pie and everything was brotherly love and peace and understanding. It's a fairy tale. From what I've read, the story was a lot different than that. When the Pilgrims came over, they came from England, as everyone knows. But what they did not realize was that the growing season in New England was much shorter than the growing season in Old England. If you look at the globe, Labrador is on the same latitude as London. It's the Gulf Stream that keeps England fairly warm. It doesn't snow much during the winter. It gets gloomy and it rains. Even in the south of Sweden, they hardly ever get snow, all due to the Gulf Stream. So when these Pilgrims arrived over here, they did not make a sufficient effort to store food for the winter because they thought they had plenty of time. Well, they caught on pretty fast when the snow started to fall. So what they did from the Massachusetts Bay Colony, they sent an expeditionary force down into what is now northeastern Connecticut. And they found some Native American villages down there where the folks had stored food for the winter because they knew it was coming. And this expeditionary force waited until the men were out hunting, and they swooped in and massacred the entire populations. The aged, the infirm, women, children, babies, stole all the food and went back to the Bay Colony. And there was a celebration because they had come back with a lot of food and no casualties on their part. So that's the real story of Thanksgiving. Not too nice. About this time in 1969, I had an interesting experience. The Native Americans, particularly those in the Southwest, as part of their religious observations, consume certain organic substances, shall we say, like what we call shrooms, which are now legal in Oregon, by the way, peyote and mescaline, and they have visions. And these are a very important part of their religious rituals. They are still allowed to do it today, even though these substances are banned by the government, because it is part of their religion. Well, back in 1969, although I should say I am not a Native American, never have been, never will be, I, at a band practice one afternoon, I consumed a certain amount of one of these substances, namely mescaline. And there's a thing that happens when you do that. First you vomit, then you trip. So I did that thing and I could not drive home. I was so whacked. So one of the other guys had to drive me home. I had to leave my car and so on. Told my wife I was just sick and I collapsed on the couch. We didn't have remote controls for the TV then, so I had to watch what was on. And what was on was the Bob Denver Show, the least funny sitcom ever. And you can imagine trying to watch that while you're stoned on mescaline. Unreal. But anyway, on the way home, I had a very profound vision. And that vision has stuck with me to this day, 60 some odd years later. I can still see it. I can still see the colors. I can still hear the sounds. A few days afterwards, when I got myself together, I wrote this poem. It's called Nyanganaway. Nyanganaway is the protagonist in the poem. The name means nothing. I just needed a five-syllable name that sort of sounded like it might have been Native American. So this was what came from my vision. In the summer of the battle, to the woodlands of his fathers, went the son of Mighty Eagle, Nyanganaway. For an omen sat he waiting, looking outward o'er the valley, crying loud so God could hear him, "Bring salvation for the red man." It has been 70 winters since. Still he sits, still he waits. The iron-fisted white man holds a blight upon the land, a scourge upon its people. No more the buffalo, too few the deer. Never again may a warrior count coop or hold his head high, lord of all he can see, as far as the rim of the world. With his terrible devices, the might of evil thoughts and the demon Adam together, the white man soars through the air, burrows in the ground, makes the bountiful earth as hard, unyielding stone. Still he cannot live in peace or without fear. The young buck taunts the old man as he carries on his vigil. The white man throws him leavings from his overburdened table. Still he waits, alone in silence, looking starward for a message. Retribution in the contrails for the murder of his people. We would do well to be like him. Heed the warnings of the spirits. Put aside our toys of thunder, for Nyanganaway, the sky is burning. Thank you very much.
Powerful.
Powerful. Indeed. Okay. Up next is Branson.
Hi, everybody.
Hold on. I'm going to mute. Following Branson will be Tom Horsky. So, Branson, you can unmute, or I'll unmute you or something.
There we go. Is that working? Looks like it is. Good evening. Mother, don't you stop praying. Father, keep right on praying. Don't you stop praying, for this old world is almost done. You gotta keep your lamp trimmed and burning. Now keep your lamp, your lamp trimmed and burning, for our world is almost done. I said, sister, don't you stop praying, brother. Don't you stop praying, for this old world is almost done. You gotta keep your lamp trimmed and burning. Now keep your lamp, your lamp trimmed and burning, for our world is almost done. Monday night spiritual for you. All right, let's do something slightly different. Come for us to pause and think of living as it was. Into the future we must cross. I'd like to go with you, and I'd like to go with you. You say I'm harder than a wall, a marble shaft about to fall. I love you dearer than them all, them all. So let me stay with you. So let me stay with you. As we walked into the day, skies of blue had turned to gray. I might have not been clear to say, I never looked away. I never looked away. And though I'm feeling you inside, my life is rolling with the tide. I'd like to see it be an open ride along with you. Going along with you. Time we borrowed from ourselves can't stay within a vaulted well, and living turns into a lender's well. So let me come with you, and let me come with you. And when we came out into view, and there I found myself with you, when breathing felt like something new, new. Along with you, going along with you.
Hey, Branson.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Is that one yours?
Jorma Kaukinen.
Jorma
called
Kaukinen.
Genesis.
Oh.
Okay.
Might have heard it.
That should have been. I might have, but didn't recognize it. Okay, up next is Tom Horsky. And then following Tom will be Karen. So Tom, you can unmute yourself.
1964, Gordon Lightfoot recorded this song called Steel Rail Blues. And last week I kind of dug it out of the coffers. And it's a great song. Here we go. Well, I got my mail in late last night, a letter from a girl who found the time to write to her lonesome boy somewhere in the night. She sent me a railroad ticket to take me to her loving arms, and the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I've been out here many long days. I haven't found a place that I could call my own. Not a two-bit bed to lay my body on. I've been stood up, I've been shook down, I've been dragged down into the sand, and the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I've been uptight most every night, walking along the streets of this old town. Not a friend around to tell my troubles to. My good old car, she done broke down, cause I drove it into the ground. And the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Yonder across the plain, the big drive wheels are pounding along the ground. I'm gonna get on board and I'll be homeward bound. Now I ain't had a home cooked meal and Lord, I need one now. And the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Now here I am with my hat in my hand, standing on the broad highway, will you give a ride to a lonesome boy who missed the train last night? I went into town for one last round and I gambled my ticket away, and the big steel rail won't carry me home to the one I love. Just don't write them that way anymore. So this one is it's based on an old 1920 song. Thank you.
beautiful.
Yeah.
It sounded wonderful.
Thank you all.
Up next is Karen Sauer, and following Karen will be Melissa and Charlie. So Karen, you can unmute.
So I don't know if you remember Tom Hicks and his Hot Licks, the song, How Can I Miss You If You Won't Go Away? This is a takeoff on that, and it's in the form of a letter. Dear Mr. Trump, the ballots are counted, we got us a brand new president. The people have spoke, you were outvoted. Then by God you went and called the whole thing fraudulent. It's time to face it, you're about to get demoted. How can we miss you when you won't go away? We've been waiting for you to get over it ever since election day. Instead of conceding, you insist you're gonna stay. How can we miss you when you won't go away? Why don't you put your big boy pants on instead of holding us for ransom? You've received your marching orders. Just give a wink when you watch your fan base shrink as you hold another rally and infect some more supporters. How can we miss you when you won't go away? The gene for chaos must be in your DNA. Hey dude, it's uber rude to overstay. How can we miss you when you won't go away? We're biding our time, get it? We're biding our time while you act reprehensible. Those lawsuits are a national disgrace. We can't wait forever for you to get sensible. Why can't you admit it? You lost the friggin' race. How can we miss you when you won't go away? Better set aside some quality time to work on your resume. The day you got defeated should be declared a national holiday. So please, please, just go away.
Yeah.
Thank you. Now for something completely different. This is a love song that I wrote called Is It All in My Head? Why do you stand so close that your sleeve touches mine? I feel your current run through me. Why do you speak so low? I must lean close just to hear. Knowing your breath in my ear will undo me. And once in a while when your hand brushes mine, is it by accident or design? I wait for words that go unsaid, and I wonder, is it all in my head? Why can't I spend an hour without thinking of you? Wondering when I'll see you again. Asking myself whether you feel as I do. Deciding you don't, oh, but then once in a while you've dropped me a line. How's everything going? I'm fine. Still I wait for words that go unsaid, and I wonder, is it all in my head? A kiss on the cheek, hug me, hello, ever so status quo. A kiss on the cheek, hug me goodbye, and I watch you go with a sigh. Why do you stand so close that your sleeve touches mine? I feel your current run through me. Why do you speak so low? I must lean close just to hear. Knowing your breath in my ear will undo me. And once in a while when your hand brushes mine, is it by accident or design? I wait for words that go unsaid, and I wonder, is it all in my head? I wait for words that may never be said, and I wonder, yes, I wonder, is it all in my head?
Wow.
Wow.
Great
song. Great song.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Beautiful song, Karen. Thank you.
Very Blossom Deary of you.
Yes.
Somehow. Thank you. That's very nice.
Love it.
That. Okay. Up next is Melissa, followed by Charlie, and you can just go right after each other, and then after them will be Chelsea. So you guys can unmute whenever you're ready.
Which one do you want to do first?
This one.
Get one more up here.
This is a tune you all know. You play along at home if you want to. It's in G. It starts on the 5. Been waiting a long time to play this. Together we stand, divided we fall. Come on, people, let's get on the ball. Let's work together. Come on, come on, let's work together. Nana people, for together we will stand. Every boy, girl, a woman, and a man. Now you and me, we ain't no fortunate sons. They wave the flag and slash the veterans' funds. Let's work together. Come on, come on, let's work together. Every boy, girl, a woman, and a man. Clean up the water, clean up the air. Keep your hands off my Medicare. Let's work together. Come on, let's work together. Now, people, for together we will stand. Every boy, girl, a woman, and a man.
Together we will stand, every boy, girl, a woman, and a man.
Thank you. Yeah. I'm sure all of you could add like a million verses to that.
I wish we could all be singing with you.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
That'd be fun.
We can't do it together, but you can, you know.
Together apart.
Yeah. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
We'll hold it.
Oops.
Thought there was something funny in there.
There you go, baby. Here am I. Well, you left me here so I could sit and
You guys sound great tonight. That's great. Awesome.
Try another one like that. Like a train's going through someplace. You hear that? There it is. Okay. Let's go.
It was my space heater.
Oh.
I could feel it all the way over here. That's what it's like.
The sun doesn't care on which side of the river, lays its head down for a rest. She's waiting for me in the land of the free. It's ironic to meet I guess. Look how the seabirds fly over the borderline. They never had to spend a dime to have a home. Look at the shape I'm in. My emotions are paper thin. They're gonna send me back again. That's the way that it goes. Over the water, over the mountains, over and over, she waits for me. Only in heaven, there are no borders. Only in heaven, land of the free. If I'd only caught that boat 300 years ago, there'd be no papers to show, not even my name. I cannot comprehend what that field they must defend, because they all pretend that we're created the same. Over the water, over the mountain, over and over, she waits for me. Only in heaven, there are no borders. Only in heaven, land of the free.
Resolve that now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that was really pretty.
Wow.
It's pretty.
Made me cry.
Thank you, Cliffy.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh.
Okay. Now for something completely different. Struck a Romeo, sings the streets a serenade, laying everybody low. The love song that he made finds a convenient street light, steps out of the shades, says something like, "You and me, babe, how about it?" Hey, Juliet says, "Hey, that's Romeo. You'll give me a heart attack." You're underneath the window, think, "Hey, la, my boyfriend's back. No, you shouldn't come around here, sneaking up on people like that. Anyway, what you gonna do about it?" Juliet, the dice was loaded from the start, and I bet that you exploded in my heart. There's a place for us.
come up on different streets. Both streets are made of shame, both dirty, both mean, but our dream was just the same. I dreamed a dream for you, now that dream is real. Now you say, look at me like I was just another one of your deals. You can fall for chains of silver, fall for chains of gold, fall for strangers and the promises they hold. You promised me anything, you promised me thick and thin. Now you say, hey, there's Romeo. You know, I used to have a scene with him. Juliet, we made love, you used to cry. Say, I love you like the stars above. I love you till I die. There's a place for us. You know the movie song. When you're gonna realize it's just that the time was wrong, Juliet. Can't do the talk like the tuck on the TV. I can't do a love song the way it was meant to be. I can't do anything, but I'll do anything for you. Can't do anything except be in love with you. All I do is miss you the way we used to be. All I do is keep the beat in bad company. All I do is kiss you through the bars of Orion. Julie, I'll do the stars for you anytime. Juliet, when we made love, you used to cry. Said, I love you like the stars above. I love you till I die. There's a place for us. You know the movie song. When you're gonna realize that it's just the time was wrong, Julia. Struck Romeo sings the streets a serenade, laying everybody low with the love song that he made. Finds a convenient street light, steps out on the stage, says something like, you and me, babe, how about it? You and me, babe, how about it?
Oh, I love it. Well, who wrote that, Charlie?
Beautiful. Park Knopfler
song. Park Knopfler.
Yeah. Dire Straits. Yeah.
Oh man, that's beautiful, a cool show. Song.
Robin Bateau, he loved that. He did
Neil.
He loved how you did it. Hi, Dan.
Hey, Neil.
Hi, everybody. Great to see you all. Neil. I am late.
Did you want to perform, or you just want to watch?
Oh, no. I'm just then listening to my friends.
Okay.
But thank you.
Up next is Chelsea. And following Chelsea will be Mike Santoro. So let me just mute everybody. And then, Chelsea, you can unmute yourself.
Good evening. Wow, it's been a while since I've heard Romeo and Juliet. Charles, that was really beautiful. You guys' set is always really nice, but that song was really good. So my usual spiel, I'm working on an album inspired by The Idiot by Elif Batuman. And tonight I'm gonna play the first two songs, including one that I just wrote and finished about an hour ago. The first one is called Something's Wrong, and this is gonna be the opening track. On the album, and it's called Two Devils. You saw the
Great job, Chelsea.
Thank you, guys. Have a great night.
Okay, up next is Mike Santoro, and following Mike will be Ellen. So Mike, you can go ahead. There, Mike. Oops, you're still muted. We're not hearing you.
You're right. I was muted. I was saying that I have a piano under here. Hopefully you can hear that and my voice. So this is a song that I wrote several years ago. My family, most of my family is back in Connecticut. And in many trips that I made back and forth, the idea of this song that I'm about to play kind of started to creep into my head. It's about kind of finding your way home, going home. I can almost smell my grandma's cooking. I'm sitting at the counter of this greasy spoon. And I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. As I'm leaving this lonely motel room. Cause soon I'll be driving back to where I belong. Yeah, to that place I first learned right from wrong. And I'm finding my way back home. Way back home. Way back home. When I was younger, I thought I knew what was better for me. Was a little sad. That new life didn't always work out so well for me till I remembered some of the things I learned from my family. I started finding my way back home. Way back home. Way back.
awesome.
That was great, Mike.
I love it. I love it.
This one, next one, I didn't write. I wish I did. I think I should have practiced it more, but we'll see how it goes.
Next is Ellen Following Ellen will be... I was muted for a moment there. Ellen will be Von Israel, and I'm muting.
It's been a very interesting day. It started off with my son, Bill, who decided to try to put all of his immediate family together and have us talk to one another. Mm. And that was the first time that we've done that. There are a lot of things that people are doing now that they didn't used to do. And so that was very interesting and a lot of fun. And we look forward to being part of such a thing again. And then I had decided to sing a song that both Wendy and I had written at different times and taken different tacks on it. And Wendy is someone, some of you know her. She has a beautiful voice. She has traveled all over the world and done many very interesting things in her life. And some of them we were able to go to, where was it, Eric, Ellen?
Ecuador.
Ecuador. And go up into places you can't imagine. And she did all of that particular thing for a little over 2 years and went from there directly to the wedding of my son. Just one thing after another. And then she also has the habit of just showing up, surprised. I'm here. And the most recent time that she did that was a couple of months ago. And she said, I'm on the phone, but if you can come downstairs, we can talk. And so she's back here and she's doing some work and also has found a small place to live in. And happily, it's only in the next town. So, and she's here to stay. This is where she wants to be. And there are a lot of family members who are very happy about that. So I'm going to sing this song about Wendy. And I know some of you knew her. And I loved it when we were here together and singing together. Going home, can't wait to see you all.
Okay, up next is Ron, and then following Ron will be Deb Goss. Ron, you can unmute.
Can you hear me?
I can.
Okay. Ellen, that was a nice song. Please send my best regards to Wendy, who I worked with for a while. I'm just going to do one song tonight. I do it annually this time of year. What did you bring to the table on Thanksgiving Day? What's the baggage you picked up along the way? Maybe a little self-pity, maybe a little self-doubt, maybe you'll worry about something you can't figure out. Don't bring that stuff with you. Just leave it parked at the curb. Make a sign, say, holy day, don't disturb. This is a time for reflection on being alive. Notice the things in this world that help us survive. The food someone puts on the table, the roof that covers your head, the have a nice day that someone you didn't know said. A sunrise taken for granted, love that you sometimes don't see, that comes from the heart, part of your family. This is a time to be grateful. It's only just one day, but people I know keep gratitude always in play. They are the saints among us, the ones who don't make a fuss, who know that the world doesn't revolve around us. They've given us this Thanksgiving in hopes that we'd understand it's time to honor the master plan. And celebrate the moment, 'cause who knows what lies in store, and rejoice we have come together once more. Day of of Thanksgiving. What are you thankful for?
Oh my God, that's gorgeous.
Beautiful, Ron. Good job.
Just beautiful.
Thank you, Ron. That was
beautiful. Your song, Ron?
Yeah.
Gorgeous. Wow.
Thank you.
What a gorgeous song.
John, and up next is Deb Goss. Let me just do the mute dance here.
Oh.
And now you can unmute yourself, Deb.
Yep. Okay, there we are. Okay, so now I'm going to sing a song about something I'm grateful for. it's my setting of a poem. I usually do it a few times around this time of year, so you might have heard it. I'll try and do my slightly faster version of it this evening. It's a setting of a poem by Joseph Campbell, who was around he was Irish from 1870 something to 1940 something. And I know David, oddly enough, Dave Weber has written a setting of this poem as well, and I have never heard it. I just know he did one, but this is my setting. So here it is. It's called a poem of Thanksgiving. And my dad would have been 100 years old this year in November. So around November, I always bring this out. I will go with my father a-plowing to the green field by the sea, and the rooks and the crows and the seagulls will come flocking after me. I will sing to the patient horses with the lark in the white of the air, and my father will sing the plow song that blesses the cleaving share. La 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 la. I will go with my father a-sowing to the red field by the sea, and the rooks and the gulls and the starlings will come flocking after me. I will sing to the striding sowers with the finch on the greening slow, and my father will sing the seed song that only the wise men know. La 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 la. I will go with my father a-reaping to the brown field by the sea, and the geese and the crows and the children will come flocking after me. I will sing to the tan-faced reapers with the wren in the heat of the sun, and my father will sing the scythe song joys for the far harvest done. La 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 la. I always choke up on that last part.
Oh, you have such a pretty voice.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you. Paul Beck said that's the Morris, with such a Morris tune.
That's, oh, yeah. It,
so maybe somebody will dance to that tune someday. let's see, I'm going to do one more. And on Thursday, I have to be Mother Goose. And I'm doing a library program online for kids. It's the theme is animals. And mostly it's barnyard animals, but this is the not barnyard animal. And I've never done this song, but you all know it. You can sing along if you want. I hope I pick an okay key. I'm not sure where it's supposed to be.
I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade. He'd let us in, knows where we've been in his octopus's garden in the shade. I'd ask my friends to come and see an octopus's garden with me. I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade. We would be warm below the storm in our little hideaway beneath the waves, resting our heads on the seabed in an octopus's garden near a cave. We would sing and dance around because we'd know we can't be found. I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden beneath the waves. We would shout and swim about the coral that lies beneath the waves. Oh, what a joy for every girl and boy, knowing that they're happy and they're safe. We would be so happy, you and me, no one to tell us what to do. Ooh, I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden with you. Octopus's garden with you. Ooh, in an octopus's garden with you. I had to say that somewhere before I tried to sing it for kids. I'll be working on that.
They'll love cute. It.
Thanks.
Okay, I'm going to finish things up with this song. Let's do the meatness here. So, fun gardening fact. The ideal time to plant garlic is 2 weeks before the ground freezes solid. Which, if you think about it, means you don't know when to plant it until it's too late. But nevertheless, we put out our garlic recently. Some say there's a season, time for every purpose. Some say there's a reason for all the things that hurt us. I don't know the master plan, just focus on the small. I plant potatoes in April, garlic in the fall. Grown-up life's a busy mix, startle, stress, and hurry. Sometimes I can't help myself, give in to the worry. Other days I take it slow and listen when the birds call. I plant potatoes in April, garlic in the fall. 'Cause there's a time for doing taxes, a time for washing dishes, a time for smelling roses, time for catching fishes, time to read, a time to write, a time to search for answers, time to leave your seat and join the dancers. Some hope politicians would be the ones to save us. Others say the answer is to bow our heads to Jesus. Not much faith in praying, less in building walls. I plant potatoes in April, garlic in the fall. 'Cause there's a time for doing taxes, a time for washing dishes, time for smelling roses, time for catching fishes, a time to read, a time to write, a time to search for answers, a time to leave your seat and join the dancers. There's a meditation in working for the future. Tender shoots, seeds, and hope, all things we can nurture. Each act of compassion shows we're in it for the long haul. Potatoes in April, garlic in the fall. I plant potatoes in April, garlic in the fall. Thank you, everybody.
Yay, I love your fishing song.
Is that your song, Dan?
That is my song. Yes, it is.
I really like
it's
that.
Fishing
I
wait song.
That. I wait for that every year, but you sometimes sing it other times too in the spring.
Spring and fall. That's my spring and fall song. Yep. Dual purpose. Okay, by the next, we're actually going to be having 3 open mics this month because there are 5 Mondays in November. So the next one is, I think it's the 30th, something like that.
Try to remember to sign up this time.
30th, yeah.
The last Monday of the month. So I will put up the sign-up sheet the next day or so. And thank you all for coming, and I hope you can come again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Dan.
Thank you.
Thank you. Everybody sounded you. So wonderful. Thank what a lovely you, night.
Great yeah. to hear everybody.
Thank you very much.
It really made me happy to have ears.
Yeah.
Everybody stay safe.
Good night, all.
Yes. Yep.
Yes. See you in a couple night, weeks. All. Bye.
Love to see you all. It's wonderful.
Ellen, beautiful song.
You too, Ellen.
Beautiful, beautiful song. And you sounded you. Great.
Oh. Yep.
Thank you.
All right, bye.
So much. We love you.
Love you.